guys, it's the ZeBu clan here, and we're bringing you an upgraded Airsoft video for more advanced players.
Yep. So, my name is ZeBu BISCUIT. You all know me as TheBlueNinja69.
I'm known as Neon in the Airsoft videos, but I'm ZeBu Bacon.
I am ZeBu Toast, and you might know me as Superfudge.
And just what Bacon said, we're going to be talking about moving from the entry level to the mid-level, or to some extent the high-level end of the competitive spectrum. So this video will maybe a little more brief than our last one. In our last video, we talked about entry-level things that you should have and should do and keep minding of. So if you are still new to Airsoft and you don't know what all of this is, here's a link right here. And this is an introduction to entry level. Other than that, we're gonna get started.
First of all, you're gonna need this. This is a banana.
Bacon. That's a friggin' banana, for freak's sake. So anyhow, we're gonna move on. So Toast, we'll get to your gun first, but before we do that, we're gonna talk about other things. We're going to leave the guns best for last, but first of all, we're going to talk about ammo. So I have here Elite Force 0.28 gram BBs. So this weight is heavier than the ones that you buy at Walmart and so on. Because since you're using much more powerful guns, they have more strength to push the heavier ammunition. This is what you want so that your shots are more accurate. But on top of that, if you'll notice, or if any of you know that Elite Force makes polished BBs, you also want to be using high quality ammo. If you use poor quality ammo, your gun won't perform as well, and eventually it could even break your gun. I guess that's all to say there.
Yeah.
I'll move on to this little piece of lethal equipment. This is a grenade. So if I unravel this orange ribbon here, you'll notice there's an orange ribbon here. Now, when you throw this foam grenade, it doesn't have any effect like exploding or making a big boom sound. This is a very simple one. If you throw it and your enemy is within this orange tape, then they're out. It's a very simple way of doing it. But most places prefer to use explosive ones that just make a crack sound. And having a grenade, especially when you get to the mid to high level area of Airsoft, you'll find that having a grenade can make a huge difference, and you can have a real edge in the battle. If you have a grenade and your enemy doesn't, you have a huge, huge advantage against them. It's very helpful to have one of these. So if you get into the mid to high level range of Airsoft, I highly recommend picking up a grenade too, because that can save your life, definitely. I think that covers everything. What to wear for Airsoft. There's entry level, which is simply a mask, and then that's kind of it. But when you get to the higher levels, you want to start wearing more tactical equipment. For example,
a vest.
A big vest like this one. You got all these pockets everywhere, so you can hold all your stuff and keep it together instead of having to reach into your pockets.
Very nice vest.
Very nice. Put that off to the side there. Very bulky, as you can see. So, I find wearing these gloves actually can make a difference on the battlefield, which is surprising since they're gloves. But they can actually make a difference. They can make you more concealed. I remember I played a game once where I was hiding in the forest, and Tree told me that he wouldn't have saw me, but he saw my hands. If I were wearing these gloves, he wouldn't have seen me. So gloves, surprisingly, can make you more concealed, but also it just kind of makes it easier when you're handling something, so you don't get blisters or anything like that when you have a sniper vest full of bullets. That's just an example, but gloves are good. Gloves are good.
Next up, we got this hat here. Nice hat, just protects the forehead, gives you some shade, and looks pretty cool. Camo, it's a cool hat. Serves some purpose.
Some purpose.
Yeah.
I suppose that covers everything, so...
Now we're gonna talk about the guns.
It's your time to shine. Tell us about
my gun. It's the GR-15. It has six adjustable stock. And it's got my iron sight scopes. I'm hoping to get some new attachments, like a scope and a laser sight. Shoots about 400 FPS. And yeah, it's a pretty good gun. Lots of quality. Yeah.
The gun features blowback, correct?
Yes.
Yes. Blowback is something you'll notice that a lot of the higher-end guns have. Whether it's necessary, it's not. Whether it's a good thing or a bad thing is something that's being very highly debated about nowadays in the airsoft community, but we're not going to get too much into detail with that. So, as you can see, Toast here runs a stock gun, and even with a stock gun, you can still do a lot of damage on the battlefield. However, the other way you can go is just loading up your gun with a lot of attachments. An example of this is Bacon's weapon.
This is my gun. This is the CM16. Picked this up in Vancouver, Canada, and cost me about $300, and I think it's around 400 FPS. I got a new battery. It can run with 8.6 and a 9.2, and I have 9.2 in here right now. And right now on this gun, I have a red dot sight here. This red dot sight will cost you about $120. Very high quality, very good. On this other side here, we got a laser and a light. The light is very good, the laser's good, it's all good stuff. That'll cost you about $75. And then we got this very cheap, but very handy grip at the front of my gun, just plastic. I got it given to me by a chap. It's a great, great thing. It helps you aim down the sights a lot steadier. Yeah, this is a great gun. I would really recommend it for anybody, even high level players. Very good.
Okay, and now we're going to get to my weapons. So we're going to start with my AEG. I have here a G&G CM16, just the same as Eric's. It's a different edition, but it's technically still the same. So I have on here a mock suppressor. This is the G&G SS100 at the end. I have a reflex sight, which I got when I started Airsoft. It came with my gun. It's not a very high quality one, but it works just fine. And then I have a bipod, which is currently folded in. It's kind of collapsed right now. I have a sling on this as well, and I also bought not one but two magazines. When you get into the high level range of airsoft, you'll find you'll run out of ammo pretty quickly, especially if you're using mid caps or low cap magazines. So getting spare mags is very, very convenient. That's all I want to talk about my gun. I just got certain attachments on it. The gun costs about $200. The red dot or reflex is probably $20. Same with the bipod. These two things kind of came with guns I bought. And the suppressor was $50. And it also features this six position adjustable stock, like so. I don't have the battery in right now, but I'll set that off there. And now we'll talk about an entirely different part of airsoft, and that is sniping. If you want to become a sniper, this is pretty much ideally what you will kind of want here as to what you can see. I did talk about what you want to get and etc. for a sniper rifle if you want to start getting into it, but I just have a Swiss Army 4x32 compact scope, and everything else about the gun is stock. I want to get a tighter barrel, so my shots will be more consistent. And then I just have a sling on this so I can shoulder it around. And yeah, that's about it for the gun.
This is an example of when you want to use heavier ammo.
Yes, the .28 gram BBs are a good example of what you want to use. If you have an upgraded spring in yours, you can even go heavier. There are, on the market, there are weights that go as high as 0.43. depends on the gun you have. Mine's an upgraded, it does have an upgraded spring inside it, so it could even shoot BBs that are even heavier than .28 and be able to shoot them consistently. So I guess that's all of our guns here. That's kind of, that gives you an idea of what you want to get for your guns and stuff. I suppose that's it for the video. So any other final notes?
No. Hope you guys enjoyed.
Is there anything left in that point?